Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Shadows of Om, Enhanced Edition 2, etc. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Off screen, I went and sold a bunch of stuff. We now have 131,000 gold, and I went to go buy bullets. Unfortunately, they only had regular bullets, so I got more bullets here. I can't put them in there yet because I have the minute meteors active, so
I'll help however I can.
So I got more bullets, and a little bit of plus one, and we got bullets, and a little bit of plus two. Hopefully we'll find some more, and she's got even more bullets down here that she couldn't fit. Those could be for me once I can actually equip them. Oh, and
I can break an arm or a leg for a couple or two.
Yes, you're fond of saying that. Pellin's shield, we had her using. Yeah, we kept that. We kept this. Yeah, I was going to switch the shield and end up not doing that. Okay. And that's it. Alright, before we're talking to, what's his name? Aaron? Thorne says, you. Girl. Hopefully he's not picking on Aerie again. We've been through that before. Aerie says, me? Aye. What are you doing here? What is she doing here? She's a member of the party. I don't understand the question, she says. The Ballspawn side is no place for a simpering child. Oh, brother. I'm not a simpering child. Spoken like a simpering child. Be gone. There's no place for you here. Why is everyone picking on her? God damn. You don't order me around. I'll go when Sapphire says to go. And I don't think she will say that. No, I won't. Ha! You've got some spirit to you. Maybe you're worthy of the Ballspawn's attention after all. Maybe. Alright, well, hopefully it doesn't get worse. Hopefully it doesn't get like Corrigan was. Because, yeah, Corrigan was downright mean-spirited. Alright, so before this guy says he can break an arm or a leg for a copper or two again, let's talk to Aaron.
Stand back for justice!
Have you properly supplied yourself for the trip, Sapphire? We must get you on your way as soon as possible. I am ready to go now.
Excellent. The ship awaits. Good luck to you. I hope we all find what we are looking for.
As do I.
Awaken, child. It is time for another test.
Damn.
Oh, please, I can't take this.
Patience, Imowen. Soon it will all end.
No! Don't do this! I don't want to die!
Silence, dog. You have no purpose but to die by my hand.
I wonder who that is.
Captors, Vulcan, Imperial.
Okay, it doesn't matter who they are now. Probably. Maybe. Just kill them all. Yeah.
You are nearly ready for her, Imowen. She will be pleased.
I guess she's not dead. He's talking to her.
This shall be your ship to the island. The bulk of your gold purchased your passage, as well as the silence of the crew.
Mm-hmm. Well, what I'm hoping... Oh, that we can get him on back. I thought it would just happen once we paid the gold. I figured the cowled wizards would just return her. But the cowled wizards don't have her at all. I guess they used to. Right, they had her and Arrhenicus. And then Arrhenicus got free. Killed them all, or at least three or four of those wizards. And Imowen was in a cell as well, so it looks like he grabbed her. And, yeah, the spell hole now. I wonder about what if his first dungeon, the one we started the game in, if he's abandoned that place fully.
Though a silence more symbolic than anything, as you may well find my men a boisterous lot at all hours, I encourage general delivery.
The personal habits of your crew are your business, Captain. Just as long as they perform as they should and deliver my people in good time.
Never a fear nor worry should cross your thoughts this evening, my lord. I've traveled the sea a good many times, and I foresee no trouble.
Then let us proceed to introductions. Sapphire, this is Captain Saemon Havarian. He and his ship will... Mr. Havarian, what is your ship called? Ah, the name changes as do the winds. Mainly, I never seem to affix the plate with the proper resin. She is the Galante for now, until whim takes me elsewhere. As for the voyage, heed my words, Sapphire, as there are dangers to the sea you may not be aware of. I saw no reason to be offensive in front of the guy. I am only yours, Captain. Yours is the voice of experience, and I will listen. A sudden squall or hidden reef could prove deadly to the unwary, though we are more likely to encounter pirates of ill repute. Aaron says, that is why I've included some protection for this voyage. Protection? I was not aware of any such plans. The captain should be consulted on all such matters. Certainly, says Aaron. I am providing an extra crew member, one that will attempt to improve the overall safety of the voyage. An extra crew member? This is Sim? Sime? Sime? I don't know how to say that. And she will be staying very... Simmy. I'm going to say Simmy. This is Simmy, and she will be staying very close to you, Saemon Havarian. For your safety, of course. Of course, Saemon says. I shall make certain that, should we be surprised at sea, death will not come from a surprise source. Says Simmy. Do I make myself clear? Saemon says, as clear as could be, m'lady, though I am not sure I approve of your tone. I assure you, nothing untoward will happen during our crossing. Simmy shall also advise you, Sapphire, says Aaron. She is acquainted with a few of the inhabitants of the island. Saemon says, then we are fully staffed and ready to sail. Best that we get underway as soon as possible. Disembark, my lord, and we shall away. Hold fast. The journey begins.
Aaron Linvale has proven trustworthy. You are soon under sail with the flamboyant Saemon Havarian at the helm. The journey is uneventful, and if there were other ships on the same course, they must have kept a discreet distance. You make good time, and soon there is a sizable island on the horizon. It might have been considered a pleasant place, but a grim shadow extends the length of it. The asylum, Spellhold, looms from a cliffside.
We have arrived, and in good time, I might add. Congratulatory remarks for all the crew, and to our visitors for their
delightful company. Yoshimo says, we had to make the best of it. I myself managed to win a fair amount of coin from your crew. They seemed to think that they were the only ones who knew how to play cards. Oddly. Simmy says, a particular congratulations to you, Captain. It was fortunate you distracted those other ships we saw in the distance. Your signals in the night, were they some type of warning? Distracted the other ships in the distance with signals in the night? More like attract ships than distract them. Saemon says, yes. Well, I thought they might be pirates, so I merely displayed a series of lights that mirrored their own. I wished to appear as though I were one of their own. Again, my compliments, says Simmy. It did seem that they truly believed your signal meant there would be trouble if they attacked. It merely proves how short of wit they can be. One must always be a step ahead of their adversaries. Or adversaries. Yoshimo says, in a step behind their friends, I trust no more will happen to hamper our success. Saemon says, I have done what I can as captain and as compatriot. I can do no more. Regardless, we have arrived. I leave you to your mission, whatever it may be. It has been a pleasure sailing in your company, but now I take my leave. I wonder what's up with this simi person. I can't look at that yet. She says, I do not trust this pirate, Sapphire. His manner is that of a fool, but his behavior during the voyage betrays a cunning mind beneath. Huh. So he's smarter than he makes himself out to be. Kill him if you wish, I don't care either way, he's amiable. Oh, I'm gonna rush toward killing him. Would make me feel safer, but, this is more like dismissive. This seems more like supportive to me. He seems amiable enough to me. Come, you'll feel better once off the ship. Agreed. Be prepared. This place is dangerous enough, even without my suspicions of Saemon. Chapter 4. Oh, wow. I have completed the task that Aaron Linvale set out for me, including destroying the rival guild that Bodhi has set up and forcing the vampire herself to flight. And now the Shadow Master has enlightened me about several things. The Shadow Thieves were the ones who attacked Arrhenicus in the dungeon that I awoke in. They had heard about my kidnapping, but not thought much of it. But then Bodhi's guild appeared, and many of the Shadow Thieves began to disappear. They managed to track down Arrhenicus's dungeon and link it to Bodhi, and I was witness to their subsequent disastrous assault. Aaron feels partly responsible for Imowyn's kidnapping and told me that she and Arrhenicus were taken to the same place, an island asylum for mages called Spellhold. The gold I supplied was used to book passage to the isle, and it is there that I will find the answers I seek. Aaron warns me, though, that the asylum is a veritable fortress meant to contain insane wizards and other deviants, quote-unquote. And even gaining entry will be a feat unto itself. Regardless, passage with a privateer named Saemon Havarian has been booked, and I am on my way. Okay. Right. And I guess once we get off this island, we'll go after Bollard Firejaw. Oh, this didn't even actually happen yet. I have arrived in Brynnlaw, and it seems that I am once more on my own. I have been told to meet with someone named Sanic, who might know how to get into the asylum. And hopefully Aaron Linvale will be more forthcoming with information and assistance regarding Imowyn and Arrhenicus. Yeah, he was somewhat. Okay. Chapter 3. So who is this person?
See battle bow, run bow, run!
Saemon looks nervous. Find out what he wants. Monsters are about. Really? Monsters? We got monsters.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
To be going off that way. I don't like the monsters about thing.
Bat kicking! For goodness!
Yes, Abel?
Yeah, where is this? I can never find it when I want to find it. Alright, protection from evil. blur and mirror image. See, I'm kind of wondering if there really are monsters or about, if it's just because we're on the ship. I'm worried about, like, saving the haste, because I know once the second time you use it, you get fatigued, but it's better safe than sorry.
Minsk and Boo, where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
You should really.
I look forward to it. I will ensure what I will take care of is.
Fine.
Wasting time here. Thank you.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Still monsters.
I fear I cannot allow you to leave my presence just yet. While I must admit to a certain fondness for you all, I have little choice in what I must do.
Huh? Really? Yeah, you were right not to trust him. What do you intend? Ask him why. What? Why such an obvious ambush? You have my gold already. It was actually working to the vampires or Phyrenicus or something like that.
My apologies, as I said. This was not my intention at all, but one must do what good business dictates.
It does not answer the question. Good business, says Yoshimo. What is this? Are we all to be slaughtered together? If my life is forfeit, how soon for yours? Think on this. I stress to you, sir, that I have done what I must, just as you will continue to do. You will continue, do you hear? That is all that I know. I will continue. Meaning those people don't actually... What was going to attack us doesn't want to stop us, doesn't want to kill us. You will recognize those that face you now. I do hope they make short work of this encounter. You have no tolerance for violence, really. Well, maybe we'll make short work. Mince says, all good peoples hang their head in shame. We are betrayed. The sailor man brings the vampires back amongst us. There shall be a mighty reckoning for this. Oh, so it's vampires? Oh, is that how we continue? Because they're going to bring us back to life as a vampire? Same and Havarian brought us to the island safely enough, but after we disembarked, we were ambushed by vampires. Seaman seemed regretful for the necessity, but it was despicable nonetheless. Parisa... Valen, Entelza, and Del. Delvana. So, we've got Delvanner. And people who know Babylon 5, you know, otherwise, yeah, that's what I'm referencing. I just don't get the referencing for Parisa. For all I know, could be one of Londo's three wives or three ex-wives. I think they're ex-wives. But yeah, that doesn't... ring a bell. Oh, so is Simi gonna help then? Alright. Oh, you know what? They're undead. Wait a second. My special undead killing mace. Must save versus death at minus negative 4 be utterly destroyed. Otherwise, still hits 2d6 plus 4. Get him. Can't save during combat.
Death to all who swear.
Does nothing.
Okay, Parisa is dead. All right, let's kill Valen in Valen's name. Whoa. Damn. Look at Mintz with 42 slashing damage. And then 2 and 2 and 7. Undead destroyed. Look at that. Draconia killed that one. So Mintz, I mean, technically it's one hit. With four kinds of damage. Yeah, he one-shot killed that vampire. A named vampire. Yeah, I have no fear right now. Oh, there's the stupid gaseous form.
That's not right.
Wow.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
The gaseous form is nothing it wishes to say. Well, how could it say anything without a mouth?
Feel the black hand of justice.
All right, that's enough. Come back.
Stand back for justice.
Oh, you were supposed to help us. You didn't lift a finger, did you? I don't think you lifted a finger at all. I knew he would prove treacherous. Our threats were sufficient to keep us safe while afloat, but there must be someone here that he fears even more. Laconia says, there can be only one who is responsible for this thief. There can be only one. The one we fought earlier and prevented from destroying your precious guild. Bodhi? Certainly this is Bodhi's doing. These creatures would not have followed Saemon of their own will. His weakness would disgust them. Yeah, I guess he did flee. We should find him. Track him to his lair. He has earned his death from this. There are more important things to worry about right now, anyway. I must see that you are able to enter the asylum. Go to the tavern. There's a tavern here? I thought this was just like an abandoned island. Speak with a man named Sanic. If there's a way into the asylum, he will know it. Yeah, I literally thought this was just a big island with just the asylum on it. And that's in case they break free, you know? Like, okay, you got out of the asylum, now you have to swim to the mainland. So I figured there was nothing else here, but apparently there's at least a tavern. I will scout around a bit and meet you at the pass leading to the asylum itself. Work with haste, Sapphire. Our enemies know we are here. She's dimension dooring away. With the vampires defeated and Saemon fled, Simmy said that Bodhi was probably behind the pirates' treachery. I must work quickly to gain access to the asylum. Simmy said to go to the local tavern and speak to a man named Sanic. She, meanwhile, will scout around and meet me at the pass leading to the asylum itself. Alright, bye. Well, now we can save. It's a good thing.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Wouldn't dream of it. Literally. If I dreamed of it, I'd immediately regret it. Got a gold in there. Whoops! Andante says, you'll pay, you will. I'll see to it. Dervish the Black says, I stand by me claims. A pox on your father's father if you think otherwise. I've never been so insulted in all my born days. You, sir, are a rotter. Stow it in your aft deck, milksop. Duel Coordinator says, gentlemen, if you please, I have three other duels to govern today, and I haven't the time for the particulars of such. Well, I think they're dueling verbally. That's what Quite all right from my standpoint. His commentary on my lineage demands blood. Dervish says, and his constant blathering demands me boot to his backside. I'll do you for that. Right straight I will. The coordinator says, then bring your weapons to bear, gentlemen. I will duly record the outcome and prevent any investigation or impropriety. Huh? Says Dervish. Andante says, he means he'll make sure I don't get in trouble for killing your sorry posterior. That's the last I hear from your pompous tongue, I swear.
See, battle bow. Run, bo, run!
Hello?
I was trying to talk to the other. You've seen your last tea biscuit, dandy boy, says Dervish. Well, sport it, sir. I shall have the Sharik appraised or apprised of the results. What's the meaning of this? Dervish is busy. Dual coordinator's busy. Callahan, courtesan, and courtesan.
I'm a fine-looking strumpet, ain't I?
Cora, a man like you could use a girl to keep you company, aye? Just a few coins and I'm all yours.
I trust all is well.
You wouldn't happen to know of a decent lass who's in need of a bit of company, would you? Send her to me, aye? Wow. Not just a duel. This guy was killed. A duel is usually like... I guess it was a duel to the death. Oh well. Hello, mate. What's a good word then? Callahan I be. Scourge of the Seven Seas. Well, Matt, what is it that you do here in Brynnlaw? Smuggling, mostly. A bit of petty theft when I be bored. You know, the usual. I don't give a crap right now if he's a criminal or not. Of course. I mean, we've been hanging out at the Shadow Thieves. Of course, the usual. What do you know about the asylum? Nothing, sir. I don't be dealing with such and like. Callahan will smuggle some olive oil for you if you wish. I got it then. Is there anything of interest happening here in town? Aye, 'tis a place of adventure, Brynnlaw is. If by adventure you mean drinking and other shore leave activities, why, the crew of the Bleeding Mary just got in. Drinking up a storm, they is. That does sound exciting. I'll be leaving now. The crew of the Bleeding... Oh, I guess that's where we... The Bleeding Mary. No, we were on another ship. That had, well, we were on a ship with a different name. I don't remember the name of it. Definitely wasn't Bleeding Mary. It was one word. That does sound exciting. I'll be leaving now. As you'd have it, darn to get your pantaloons in a knot. Okay. Boo says he doesn't fully trust you, half-orc. Your hamster should have more faith, Dorn says. Giant space hamsters aren't easy to fool. I'll do everything in my power to prove myself worthy of your hamster's trust. Really? Why would Dorn give a crap? You will? Good. That's good. Madness. He is insane. He doesn't have his uses, but that was a remarkable and uncharacteristic show of restraint. Exactly. There's no joy in matching wits with the witless. Okay, we're trying to loot this stuff. Oh, that sounds familiar. So, not sure if he's yelling oil. Oh, that goes under that. Okay. Yeah, so we're definitely going to explore this place. Oh, hi. Pirates!
Your life shall be mine.
City's always teeming with evil and decay. Let's give it a good shake and see what falls out!
this one's not hostile. At least not yet.
Seas are sure rough this time of year.
What do you want? Nobody gets on the pirate lord ships. Not no one. Where can I find this pirate lord? Look, I'm not supposed to speak to anyone. You can talk all day about whatever you want, but no one gets aboard the ship. That's all there is to say about that. Well, I have more to say about that. I bet he's just fussy about keeping his poop deck clean, though. What is this? Says the same exact thing. Okay. What if I offered you gold just to look around? Would you be open to that? Okay. Not open to it. If we just walk on here anyway.
Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
All talk, no action, huh? Well, there's nothing to see on the ship anyway. Stop getting...
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Stop getting stuck.
Bad kicking for goodness!
I'm just trying to peel back the fog of war as much as possible. It's my little fun thing to do. Yeah, I can't get all... Why is it so much lately?
Where Minsk goes, evils! Jump on my sword while you can, evil! I won't be as gentle!
It doesn't happen that often that we get stuck, but now it's like every time.
Live by the sword, live a good long time!
Alright.
Minsk, you talk too much and too loud. So this is pretty cool. I had no idea we'd run into another city like this. Or town, rather.
Stand back for justice!
Mm-hmm. Plane darts. Ginia? Hail to thee!
I'm a fine looking strumpet, ain't I?
Please, sir, do you have any money to spare? I can't go back to the guild until I have something. That's an awfully mean thing to say. To the guild. Of course I can spare a coin. Why is it that you worry about returning home empty-handed? Or back to your guild empty-handed? You seem like a good person, sir. I will tell you if you promise not to tell Kremi. Who is Kremi? Kremi is the source of my trouble, sir. Count yourself all the luckier if you don't know him. I wish I didn't. I should begin with my name, Ginia. I grew up here in Brynnlaw. My father was a tailor until he was killed, and my mother is long dead. My lord, things have not always been like this. Brynnlaw was once a pleasant town, though my memories may be influenced by happier times in my own life. Go on. Regardless, life was hard, but it had its pleasures. We lived on fish and our produce. The asylum offered employment to many of us. Then the pirates arrived, led by the despot Desharik. Well, we heard about him. Desharik had lost a war with another pirate king. Forced to this island, his ships invaded the town. They took our homes. Desharik killed our mayor and dumped his body into the sea. We were forced out into the streets. We begged the asylum to offer us shelter, but the wizards within locked the doors against us. My father could take no more injustice. The wizard. Oh, so is it the Keld wizards then at Spellhold? Are we going to find any of them alive? There? Yeah, don't tell me, guys. I'm just kind of wondering out loud. It's interesting to wonder, you know, what's going to happen next. But, yeah, so I'm guessing that's... Yeah, I'm guessing they're in the same spot. Right? Imowyn and Arrakis, both at Spellhold. Arrakis breaks out of jail. Kills at least some of the wizards enough to, you know, be unmolested by them. And then takes Imowyn out of her cell and a bunch of other people out of their cells, I guess, and starts experimenting on them. And, you know, looks like he killed everyone. It looks like Imowyn died as well, but he was talking to her as if she was still alive. So maybe all those people are still alive. Anyway, he tried to get back into our house and was executed for breaking the law of the pirates. Once they've stolen something, the owner has no claim on it. Jasharik said that we would have to pay for our father's crime, quote-unquote. He gave us to Kremi, his lieutenant, as a reward for service. He put me to work as a courtesan for the drunken pirates. It's horrible, sir. He says that he'll kill my brother, Aeson, if I don't do it. Why have you not gathered your brother and run away from this man? There is no escape for Aeson and me. There is a smuggler who will take us, but we cannot afford to pay him. There is nowhere to run on this island. All right, where is this smuggler? I will pay for you and your brother's passage. I will also ensure that Kremi never bothers you again. Kremi can be found near the inn. The manager, the smuggler's name is Callahan. Oh, he will be near the docks. Thank you for your offer, but please be careful. Yes, Callahan, we just saw him. Ginia told me of how Jasharik took control of the isle and how Kremi holds her brother captive in order to force her service as a courtesan. I said I would help, possibly by paying Callahan the smuggler to take them both off the isle. He is near the docks. I will deal with Kremi, too. He is near the inn. Okay. I hope that Callahan will take us with him when you kill Kremi. He said that he could set us up with jobs in Olgoth's beard near Baldur's Gate. Oh, yeah. As long as you don't run into that crazy demon in the basement. Just kidding, we got rid of that thing. What was his name? Aklatek? We're not gonna kill anything, we're gonna pay someone, apparently. He's this way. Oh, he's a regular old pirate. Let's talk to him. Oh, he's the one. Never mind, he won't let us. No matter what you say.
Who wants to die?
Don't get these people crazy. Maybe like, who said that? Maybe you'll die and then attack. I know, I think I know him. Do I know you? Callahan don't be owing you money, do he? Oh, there's no way I'd remember this, so I'm gonna take it as true. It's been a long time since I played the end of Baldur's Gate, the first one. I do know you. Are you not Callahan the sailor, lately of Olgoth's beard? You warned me about Mindas. I do remember the name Mindas. The very same. Mistress Mallory is a mean one, she is. What happened? Were you yeah, it's nice to see you again. What can you tell me of this town? Anything interesting happening? Aye, there's a place of adventure, Brynnlaw is, if by adventure you mean drinking and other shore leave activities. Why, the crew of the Bleeding Mary just got in. Drinking up a storm, they is. Oh. Yeah. What happened? Were you forced to leave? A sad, sad tale, 'tis that you're about to hear. Mistress Mallory got it into her head that Callahan was spreading malicious rumors about her. I admit I may have been free with the tongue wagon, but 'tisn't like my stories be untrue. Mallory has connections on account of her activities. She had Scotty McAverstein give old Callahan a sound beating and a ticket to Brynnlaw. Brynnlaw, here I've been ever since. I found me place in the smuggling trade. Things could have been worse. So what about... Hello, Callahan. I'm here to speak to you about Ginia and Azon. Aye, good kids. Sad tale. You be involved in this somehow? 'Tis the first that I'd be hearing it, if you are. I want to help them escape this island. Can you offer them passage? That I can, for 100 gold piece per head. If you can pay, I'll take them to Ogoth's Beard. Thorella will take care of them. Thorella. It's in one of the stores, right? The names are familiar, but I don't remember. Well, you just... I know, he's like... I'm just curious to see his response to this. Why don't you just take them out of the goodness of your heart? I tell you, sir, I would like to offer him passage for free, but I got neither money nor ship. Someone will have to pay. How's about you paying? Fine, I shall pay. Then we be agreeing. Their passage is secured if you can get them away from that bastard Kremi. Send them to old Callahan when you've got things arranged. I paid the smuggler Callahan to help Ginia and her brother. He'll take him off the island as long as Kremi cannot interfere. Aye, 'tis true. I'll take him to Ogoth's Beard and send him up with a woman named Thorella. Don't you worry yourself none. Alright.
Every hamster has his day. Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
We'll talk to her again because we're going to head back this way. I'm just going to explore right now. This is exploring time.